My topic is dentist and bioterrorism preparedness, a need of emerging bio war. So the phrase alone could send chills down the spine, but what are they, how do they work, and what are we really at risk? So the question arises, what is bioterrorism? It is a terrorism involving the intentional release of dissemination of biological agents, and these agents are bacteria, virus, fungi, and their toxins, and it may be naturally occurring or a human modified form. And this attack is deliberately release of virus, bacteria, toxin, and other harmful agents used to cause illness or death in people, animals, or plants. And these agents are typically found in nature, but it is possible that they could be mutated or altered to increase their ability to cause disease and make them resistant to current medicine, or to increase their ability to spread in the environment. And they can be spread through air, water, or food. And bioterrorism is an attractive given because biological agents are relatively easy and inexpensive to obtain and can be easily disseminated and can cause widespread fear and panic beyond the actual physical damage that can cause to terrorize a civilian population or to manipulate the government. So the use of biological and chemical agents at a small or large scale weapons has been actively explored by many nations and terrorists. So the first bio war reported in the history in 1346, that was Black Death among the Europeans, and it was said to begin with the Mongols, and it is believed to have recorded the account of the earliest use of plague as a war weapon. While in 1763 to 1761, French and Indian war was fought in North America between France and England, where they contaminate the blankets, and which result in the pandemic epidemic in India. While even before the 600 BC, the food was filled and cadavers are contagious and they're harvesting and cattle and to weaken the enemy. And in World War II, it was reported that Germans attempt to infect the cattle. So in further than World War II, Japanese program that includes anthrax, plague, cholera, and shigella, and more than 10,000 prisoners believed to die as an experiment infecting between 1932 to 1945. So further, immediately after the World War II defensive program was launched in 1953 with objective to throw from the biological attacks. In 1982, scientific from the former USS are involved in biological weapon research defect to the band. Even in 1947, there are the cults members contaminate the salad bar with Salmonella typhoid in Oregon. And in 1992, recent attack planned by the Minnesota militia. And in 2001, anthrax releases, and this anthrax was used in series of attacks on the officers of several United States senators. And the anthrax was also used as a powder form, and it is delivered by the mail. So biological agents are categorized by the U.S. Center of Disease Control and Prevention into three groups. Category A, which include the high priority agent pose a risk to national security, and it has a high mortality rate and have potential major public health impact, and it may cause public panic, and it requires a specific public preparedness. And it includes tularemia or rabid fever. It has a low fatality rate and it can be treated. Further, the anthrax is a non-contagious disease which is caused by the spore-forming bacterium Bacillus anthracis. And others are the Yersinia pestis, Francisella tularensis, Filoverdium, which includes Ebola virus, Marburg virus, discovered in the Marburg, Germany. And the arena virus have greatly reduced fatality rate, but the larger presence chiefly in Central Africa and South Africa. The category B agents are moderate, easy to disseminate and have low mortality rate, and it results in a moderate incidence and low death rate, and it requires enhancement in diagnostic capacity, and it includes brucella, food safety threat, for example, from Salmonella species, E. coli, Shigella, and Staphylococcus aureus. Even with the water supply threat, for example, Wilbrook cholera or Crispodium marburg. Category C agents are emerging pathogens that may be engineered for mass dissemination because of their ability is for production and dissemination, and it has a high mortality rate or ability to cause a major health impact. For example, Nipah virus, Hantavirus, SARS, Flavivirus, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Ebola virus, and certain hemorrhagic fever viruses. In this category, A is the most dangerous for the health impact. And the role of dentists play a very important role towards the preparation of bioterrorism attack. Since bioterrorism attack is low risk and high impact event, and preparedness is an essential component in both detection and its management. And dentists can provide valuable service to the patient, so the epidemic bed or hospital become filled. So the alternate site for providing healthcare will be required, and dental offices could fill in that need. So before the bioterrorism attack, education of the dental professionals regarding the medical and oral manifestation of the disease and the result from the bioterrorism attack. And also dentists can educate their patients and correct the misinformation which are leading to panic in the society. Dental hospitals serve as a mini hospitals, and also dental offices can serve as a stockpiling sites for materials and supplies to be distributed in the event of a bio war. And during the bioterrorism attack, public information about the sign and symptom, educational program for public interest, and how to manage, how to prevent, and educate their patients for the spread of the disease, and also the surveillance and notifications. Different immunization, modification, decontamination, infection control of the hospital management, and medical care augmentation. After the bioterrorism attack, dentists may provide local surveillance to detect any spreading of the disease beyond the original area, and attack and reemergence of the infection in the original area. Also, the data can be collected by the dentist from the data sources, which include hospital, local clinics, laboratory, even the drug sellers. And these forensic services also helpful in after the bioterrorism attacks. So, preparedness and response of bioterrorism attack require responsibility of any healthcare worker. So, in the first phase of the preparedness, worker in surviving infection disease and identification of the biological agents that cause disease and their modes of transmission and development of prevent and control strategies. And also the syndrome survival has been used for early detection of outbreaks to monitor the disease and provide reassurance that an outbreak has not been occurred. Even the emergency and disaster health department must engage in the preparedness of the activity. While in the early warning phase, it requires continuous evaluation and notification, compilation, and interpretation of epidemiological data. And it requires early detection and rapid investigation to identify the magnitude of the attack and to implement effective interpretation. Now in the third phase, the notification phase, it is mandatory to report an unusual syndrome or rise of the disease to appropriate authorities. And this phase includes epidemiological investigation, quick laboratory support, quarantine, isolation, and even keep healthcare facilities geared up for the management in evolving the public health facilities for control. While in the response phase, here the assess the situation of the development of action plan accordingly and the implementation of the action plan, which include investigation of the outbreak and increase in the acceleration of the disease, collection of the samples, laboratory testing, and it is also having to alert the hospital about the do's and don'ts circulated through the electronic or print media, and also the public sector's education and training for the capacity building is also needed. So forensic or dentologist in bioterrorism. Also in the recovery phase, public authorities are issued to item utilized during the response phase and replenished. And the necessary modifications are incorporated in the contingency plans of the future. And forensic or dentologists will work closely with the disaster mortuary operational response team, team wards. In this case of unidentified or unknown bodies with a facial or multiple body injuries, which may cause death, like ligature mark, bite marks, or visible injury inside the oral cavity, any deformity or disfigurement of the skull, it needs a medical-legal concern. So because of the recent the outbreak, the doctors, mortuary technicians, and staffs are at the high risk to particularly dangerous hazards to organ fluid secretion, and even after the highest precautions. So forensic or dentologist and hospital model can be utilized for obtaining specimen as per the working protocol measures for taking with the deceased body should be followed. And even the care should be taken for the spread of the disease to healthcare workers, and less invasive procedures for identification of the victim should be carried out, like photograph, virtuosity, which combined with the surveying technology, pathology, radiology, image processing, computer science, physics, and biometrics, even the 3D facial reconstruction with the help of the skeletal remains, and by using the 3D imaging for post-mortem victims, if any fracture lines are present. Post-mortem activities should be conducted with focus on avoiding the infection of aerosol generations is likely to develop, ensuring the appropriate injury control and personal protective equipment are used to, and all the precautions are taken according to the guidelines of the World Health Organization and Center of Disease Control. And precautions should be taken while handling the specimen suspected of confined cases. So it has been noted that the cost.
Naira, can it go because it's 13 minutes already.
Last one. The clinical autopsy done in the dead body of the COVID-19 patients, it has been noted that the virus was active in mouth, throat, and nasal area 18 after years. So it has been advisable to take the precautions, pre-treat and others for the procedures. Thank you. These are my references.